Hello, multi-microfossils. That's my malt mention, and a big multi-mention thank you to Hugh and Lucy, who are, and I have to mention this, palphontologists. It's an academic discipline, palphontology. It is the study of microscopic fossils. Oh, but I pour more than that. And this, my merry maltsters, is Ralfy Review 746. Wonderful. What I have here is a bottle of Scotch whisky. It is bottled at 57%. Well strong. 4 years old. Sorry, I'll repeat that because you might have thought, what? It's 4 years old. 4 years old. Yeah, unusual. And it's from an undisclosed Campbeltown distillery, which in my opinion starts with Glen. There we go. But I won't give the game away, you know. Oh, I mustn't tell you what it is, blah, blah, blah. And I'd like to tell you what it smells like, but to be perfectly honest, my nose is slightly bunged up with a little cold infection. So I'm going to have to rely on the fact that I have been tasting this over the last few weeks. And therefore, I'm going to have to resort to memory. There we go. Now, apart from this bottle of four-year-old single malt, I have two other bottles of four-year-old single malt, which I'm going to talk about after this review, introduce them, and tell you a bit more about them. But back to this specific bottle here, which says in the label, where's my steampunker? Yes. Where would I be without it? Distilled in April 2014, bottled in 2018 from unchill filtered, natural colour, two refill bourbon hogsheads. A bourbon hogshead, just to let you know, is a traditional bourbon barrel which has been extended to increase its capacity. That is one interpretation. Another interpretation of a bourbon's hogshead is a sherry hogshead that's been made up using ex-bourbon staves and has had sherry in it. Never take one meaning from a definition of a cask, by the way. There are permutations. Mention that in passing. So what have we got here? The nose is very young, quite barley sugar, very fresh and spirity for the simple reason the spirit's only 4 years in the cask, which is not quite the youngest it can be. So long as it's been in the cask for over 3 years and a day, the spirit, raw British spirit or new make spirit or claret as it's called in production, can thereafter be called and designated Scotch whisky, so long as it has been bottled in Scotland. That's a malt that applies to, by the way, just in case you're getting confused. Confusion can happen. Taste wise, we're talking 57% here. Oh. Do not put naked flames near this. Where's my water? Right, before I go any further, at 4 years old, the spirit is still very spirity. The cask really ideally needs to be a wet cask that's got previous content from previous maturation, in this instance, bourbon, as far as I'm aware. Now, there's a couple of casks been put together, all good. And so you're not a single cask, just to clarify that. There's two casks. What's important to know from that is you can put two gas casks together and you will still retain almost a single cask character. But from experience and talking to people in the industry, it's once you put more than 14 to 15 casks together, that's when you actually lose a certain amount of singularity from a cask influence. Again, I'm not explaining myself terribly well, but because it seems a bit of a contradiction, if you put 15 casks together, how the hell are you going to get a single cask character? Well, you're not, but you get a sort of continuity of the single cask that can go for as many as combining 14, 15 casks, but not much more than that. The blend becomes simply more blended, whether it be a blended Scotch or single malt. Moving on, I'm going to add 1 teaspoonful of water to this, but I recommend that with young whiskey, it's a short, dynamic event, however it's bottled, and don't expect any sort of length of anything, but it's rather like a fireworks show that's been compressed, instead of lasting 5 minutes, it's been compressed into 15 seconds. And so you've got to treat it as such. You've got to look at these whiskies and take them at face value, knowing that they're going to provide you with a very interesting, singular experience simply by virtue of the fact that you know you're tasting a 4-year-old whiskey, and therefore it gives you your bearings as to what a very young whiskey actually tastes like. So that when you buy your non-age statement whiskey, you can tell whether from your memory banks whether it's nearer 4 years or 14 years. And then you can relay that to the price you paid to help you decide whether you get value for money. Yeah, it's the way it works. It's called business. So, nose from memory, rich, butterscotch, barley sugar, citrus sour, slightly raisiny, sultana. There's that kind of slightly fruity spice thing going on. There's definitely that bourbon vanilla honey contribution. It's fairly dramatic, stark and simplified. But the thing is that in being so, initially you might be disappointed in it, but the more you spend time and let your palate get used to it, the more you start to appreciate it in terms of the value of what it actually is. That you could go out and get other bottles of 4-year-old whiskey, which they're just not this, it's just not this caliber at all. And there's something I'll touch on with these two bottles here. Taste. Dramatic. Quiet. Solventy. Resinous. Sharp, spicy, rich, really good mouthfeel, honeyed most definitely, almost sour honey, muscovado, touch of brown sugar in the background, nice slightly savoury brown sugar, there's a certain meaty or umami component on the development. There's not a huge development. This whiskey's all up front because it's only 4 years old. It hasn't had much time to find its feet. But you put a young spirit in with a pretty aggressive cask, the two will jostle away, they'll meet in the middle fairly early on, and this is what you get. Back to the taste. Watch, by the way, I've noticed with this, if I add too much water, it drowns relatively quickly, which is what I'm not expecting. So I would recommend with young whiskies, just add a bit drop water and a bit more of a drop of water and then some more drop of water until you find that happy medium. And don't be afraid to leave it in the glass for a long time, because you will find that once the spirit in the cask jostle for power of the event, things settle down and they'll sort of move softly between each other's influences over time. So don't underestimate the evolution in the glass that you can get from young whiskies. I've had this before, so I've got experience about it. Just sharing. There is a really interesting vegetal note in there. I couldn't quite pin it down, actually. It's slightly angelica. Sage, kind of herbal green, there's a green note in there. And I really think it's actually coming from the grain itself, that it's been a relatively sour mash in terms of production of Scotch whisky. So, but by the way, this can happen occasionally. You can be tasting a whisky and it may seem very dry, almost slightly bitter grain notes. And one reason for that is when a wash has been sitting in the wash back having fermented and it doesn't go immediately into the still. You know, it's got the alcohol in there, it's cooled down, it starts to kind of change a little bit. And also another factor is that if you have the wort, which is kind of left sitting, full of sweetness, of course, full of sugar, bacteria and perfectly natural, bacteria and natural yeasts can get in. So if it's left, say, over the weekend, it wouldn't be quite as sweet on the Monday morning as it was on a Friday afternoon when it was finished in the wort tub. So you've got that as well, and you notice these little details over time with your connection with whiskey. And every now and again, you get the sour mash phenomenon in Scotch, particularly single malt. And of course, you'd really notice it here in a 4-year-old rather than a 10-year-old, simply because it's so much younger, it's so much less maturation, that the rawness and the freshness of the distillate is simply, it's not mellowed over time. Because that's one of the things that a cask does. It just mellows spirit, even before cask influence moves in. And so you've got a fairly raw spirit expressing itself quite dynamically and then being contained by an equally dynamic cask. And this is the result. And I recommend this, seriously, because it's unusual. A 4-year-old single malt, there's very few bottlers out there have the balls to put that sort of young age statement on their whiskey. For the simple reason that there's this dogma out there that, oh, who wants to buy such a young whiskey? Well, if the bottler's integrity is intact and if you're going to get a juicy result at an accessible price, why not? The market is definitely ready for it, and I certainly applaud bottlings like these. Now, the finish is short, sharp and shocking, just to let you know. There is this kind of slightly spicy, you think it's spicy, but it's more the grain sour, the grain dryness that's coming through into the finish, with a little bit of honey and, give me a second, just double check. Yep, and sourness, grain sour and honey. Short, sweet, simple, but quite vocal as well in what it does in the palate. It goes right down the middle of your tongue, straight down. And in doing so, one of the things that I'm really enjoying about this malt mix is it's giving me a sensory experience different from what I'm used to with many single malts, which are aged for longer and have more cask engagement over time. So it's exotic. And in that respect, if you're a real malt head and you're looking for a new experience from single malt whiskey, look out for really young 4 or 5-year-old single malt whiskies. Because the bottom line is, when you've got small independent bottlers, or even official bottlers, that they're not really going to bottle anything that's going to be an initial bad impression, particularly if they're an official bottler. And if they're an independent bottler, they know that they're connecting directly with the hardcore anorak market, which is definitely ready to experience this and enjoy the experience. Now, don't get me wrong, this is not a stellar whiskey by any means, but it's a very competent, individual and singular experience which I have been enjoying because it works. It really just works. What will I give it? A malt mark. 85 out of 100. A multi-marky. Lovely. Now, I've got two other bottles here, 4 years old. This is one from the Good Spirits Company, which, to be honest, I'm not actually going to review because Well, I'll maybe review it later. We'll see how it goes. If you would like me to review it, just leave your requests in the comment below and I'll review it. So I'll leave it to you. If I get more than 15 requests to review this 4-year-old Bunahabin, which, by the way, is heavily peated Bunahabin. So this is 4 years of peated single malt from Good Spirits Company in Glasgow. Then I'll go ahead and I'll review it. But what I will do is I'm going to be reviewing this Coxwold 4-year-old whiskey. This is really interesting stuff, and I just more or less tripped over it when I was in a bottle shop recently. And it's English whiskey. Fantastic. I'm fine with that. In fact, I think it's just a sort of kick up the backside that the Scotch whisky industry needs when English distilleries are prepared to boldly put on age statements where many Scotch whisky producers don't. And again, so you say, I can hear you. Say, oh, Ralphie, leave the age statement things alone. But it does concern me that it's the thin end of the wedge. You know, what next? Bottled at 38%? It's, you know, these things get talked about. Never take 40% as cast in iron policy with Scotch whisky. You know, they could in the future decide to drop the strength if the market would tolerate it. And that concerns me. And of course, I can be contradicted about this. Oh, Ralphie, that's not going to happen. And sure, I'm just giving you a perspective and opinion, but I'm doing so from someone that has a very particular overview globally of what's going on out there. You know, you do start to notice the patterns. So I'm delighted to, in fact, I'm definitely going to review this. Sorry, Patreon pals. For those who subscribe to my Patreon site for the additional videos, that are just on that site as a thank you to the subscribers. I didn't actually mention that I was going to be reviewing Coxwold, 4-year-old English single malt whisky, which fascinatingly they say is blended. And of course it's a blend of single malts. Great. But I'm going to review this. In fact, I'm going to review this next because I have been so enjoying this and I think there's nothing more effective at kicking the Scotch whisky's backside as regards resting in its laurels than when English whisky distilleries bottle quality with an age statement and at 46%. Bingo. I'm Ralphie, I'm done and dusted. Pop back again for my extras, 746, in which I will be showing you, describing to you and actually illustrating the shape of the taste of whiskies, and it'll be based in this bottle here. This is serious, proper, authentic, original, anorak stuff, and I'm telling you, malt mates, you'll only find it here at ralfy.com because this is the cutting edge of whisky anorakianism. I'm confusing anachronisms with anorakisms. Anyway, anorak stuff. See you soon.